Namaste to everyone. This is Madhuri at Science at Your Tips. Today we are going to discuss few questions from our NCERT 9th class textbook, chapter 9, Force and Laws of Motion. Here we are going to discuss both blue questions, that is in-text questions, along with that exercise questions. So in part 1, we'll complete blue questions. In part 2, exercise questions. Let us start this. The first question in page number 118 in our textbook from Force and Laws of Motion. Which of the following has more inertia? A rubber ball and stone of same size. You know already that inertia depends on the mass of the object. So here rubber ball is having less mass. Stone has more mass because they have given already that both are having same size. And B question, bicycle and a train. Train has more mass, so inertia also is more for that. Then question number C. A 5 rupee coin and 1 rupee coin. 5 rupee coin has more mass, so more inertia will be there for that. Coming to the second question. In the following example, try to identify the number of times the velocity of the ball changes. So here they have given one situation, how many times the velocity of the ball changes, that we have to identify. A football player kicks a football to another player of his team who kicks the football towards the goal. The goalkeeper of the opposite team collects a football and kicks it towards a player of his own team. Also identify the agent supplying the force in each case. So here in this instance, if you observe, there are totally four situations. Four times the velocity of the ball changes. How it is? First, player 1 changes the velocity of the ball by kicking it. Player 2 also changes the velocity by kicking that towards a goal. Then, third situation, goalkeeper changes the velocity by collecting the ball. Then, fourth situation, goalkeeper changes the velocity by kicking the ball. So, four times the velocity of the ball changes. Now, let us see the third question. Explain why some of the leaves may get detached from the tree if we vigorously shake the tree. So here we have to discuss about inertia of rest. The leaves of the tree are in inertia of rest. Whenever we are shaking the branches, then what happens? They will come from state of rest to state of motion. But the leaves, as they are having inertia of rest, they don't want to come from rest position to motion. So that is why what happens? These leaves tend to be in a state of rest. What is the reason here? Because of inertia. So that is why they get detached from the tree. Even it happens in the case of fruits also. When you are shaking a mango tree, all the mango fruits will start falling down. The reason is, fruits are in inertia of rest. Let us see the fourth question. Why do you fall in the forward direction when a moving bus brakes to a stop and fall backward when it accelerates from rest? So here in this question, first thing, when brakes are applied on the bus, in this situation, you are already in the state of motion. You don't want to come into the state of rest because you are having inertia of motion. So what happens here, whenever the brakes are applied on the bus, your lower part of the body is in contact with the bus, will come into the state of rest. But what is happening?
upper part of the body does not want to come from state of motion into state of rest because of inertia of rest. That's why you will fall in forward direction. Second situation. What is happening here? The bus is in rest. You are standing there in the bus. But whenever it is starting, whenever the bus is starting, what happens? You are going to fall backward. Here in this case, we have inertia of rest. Your lower part of the body will come from in a state of rest to state of motion whenever the bus starts. But upper part of the body is still in inertia. That is why it will not come from the rest to motion position. That's why you are going to fall backward whenever the bus starts.
Now let us see the remaining questions, blue box questions, second blue box questions in our force and loss of motion lesson given in page number 126. First question, if action is always equal to the reaction, explain how a horse can pull a cart. So to understand this question, to answer this question, just to recollect what you have learnt in our previous class. In 8th class, we have learnt about friction. There you have learnt that when you are applying the force on the ground with your feet in the backward direction, ground will push you in the forward direction. So there actually we didn't learn about third law of motion, but we are able to understand that. The same thing is happening here also. When horse is pushing the ground with its feet in the backward direction, the ground pushes the horse in the forward direction. As horse is tied to the cart, cart also will start moving. From state of rest to state of motion, it will start moving. So this is the reason a horse can pull a cart. Second question. Explain why it is difficult for a fireman to hold a hose which is ejecting large amounts of water at high velocity. Here this person is extinguishing the fire. While extinguishing the fire, he is holding a pipe, that is a hose will be there at the ending. From there the water is going to come out. So there water is coming with a large force. So whenever it is coming out with a large force, large velocity, what happens? Again, equivalent amount of reactional force, reaction force will be there in the backward direction from water onto the hose. So as a result, it becomes difficult for fireman to hold the hose.